You thought it was only going to be 2 weeks off, so you've gone through everything on Netflix and scrolled through YouTube a million times and there's no new videos for you to watch. You're sick of listening to your neighbors on the phone. You've done enough push-ups and squats for the day and you basically just can't afford to do any more because your chest is so tight and your legs are sore. What do you do? Well, next thing you start looking at is, how can I make money online? And you scroll through and you find stuff like how to answer surveys for a few cents each. You're like, well, I've got enough time. I might as well answer a few of these. You make a buck or two and you kind of get a bit sick of that. What do we do next? How do we make money online during quarantine? Join me for this video to find out. Thanks for joining me on YouTube. It's Jason Pizzino. I noticed many of you haven't subscribed yet, so be sure to do that down below. Hit the subscribe button and the bell notification icon so you can be informed when more videos like this pop up. Let's jump into today's video, and it is, how can we make money while we are in quarantine, while we are just sitting around on the couch, barely allowed to go outside, even walk around in the parks because the parks are closed. What do we do? I want to mention first up, there are dozens, hundreds, probably thousands of these sorts of videos on YouTube, blog posts, websites, Instagram stories, the list goes on how to make money online. Now, if you're watching this, maybe you're trying to figure out if there's another little way that you haven't thought of yet, another little way that is easier than the last ones. Maybe there's something else that resonates more with you and you might give that a crack. I want to say they're all pretty much the same, but don't click off yet. The main reason that we don't do these things is our mindset. And yes, it sounds too hard, sounds unsexy, uninspiring. Oh, I've got to change all the crap that's going on up in my head in order to be able to generate more money for myself. But generally that's what it is. That's been my experience. That's been the experience with the people that I have worked with, coaching them through their investment journeys. It's all something going on up in the head. Having said that, I still will talk about things that we can do that we can earn money online with. But I want to throw in just a little bit more of a psychological mindset point around them. It's maybe something that hasn't sparked your interest yet, maybe something that can tick it over, get your cogs working and think, maybe I can do that thing that I've already heard of a million times and work on something else that can get me the results that I'm wanting. So with that said, let's dive into today's video and find out new ways that we can make money from the same old online things. First being right here, YouTube. Yes, it's something that you can make money on, and it needs to be done in a specific way. If you've ever watched enough YouTube, you might have already started to notice that there is a particular pattern to how these videos are made. In particular, like this one here, what I'm using here are searchable words, things that are coming up that are relevant at this point in time, quarantine, maybe you can put some hashtags around this specific virus, but definitely don't title the video the actual virus name because that'll get you demonetized. But it's more searchable, it's more relevant right now. So essentially making relevant content. The problem with a lot of YouTubers or people getting into the YouTube or Instagram space is that they start to make blogs, they start to make travel things, they start to make things about their everyday life. But the sad reality is no one cares. They don't know who you are. So why are they gonna watch your stuff? Unless it's really, really high quality travel or interesting stuff about your life, no one really cares. And that was the sad reality that I had to face going through the blogging stage, and many other people I know in the space have had to. And then you've got to pivot and find out what it is that you truly love to discuss and talk about. You build a big enough following over time, maybe one or two people are going to care what you do in your everyday life. And then that's how the blog starts as well. But initially, using YouTube as a search mechanism, as a search tool, which is essentially what it is, owned by Google, they're both search engines. So people come on here looking for stuff. They come on, how can I make money during quarantine? How can I lose my fat while I'm sitting at home? What exercises can I do at home? All that sort of stuff. What can I cook? What art things can I do? What can I do when I'm bored? Those ones are quite big at the moment. So making relevant content that is searchable is definitely one way to make some extra income. And of course it takes some time to build up the following and the base. Having said that, if you do start with a small base, you start with nothing and you're just making some good quality content, you can sell products on the side, which leads to my second thing, and that is selling courses. Online courses are a great way to make another source of income, especially if you are discussing something that you love. And I don't suggest doing anything apart from the thing that you love. As you can see here, my channel is full of personal finance and investing and frugal living, anything around money. I love it. That's what my friends see me as. That's what I always get told. So I thought, why don't I start the channel and do it more in regards to something that I love? You know, I get called frugal. I get called a tight ass. Big deal. I love it. I love money. I love the process of getting it. I love the process of distributing it. It's just the whole thing that I enjoy. So I encourage you to find something that you really enjoy doing and then start to put out the content, because along the way you find out things that you don't know about it. And I've found out a lot of things I didn't know about finance. Like I'm just a student, just as the next person. And what you might think then is, well, I don't know enough about something. And like I just said, I don't need to know everything there is about finance. I just need to know 10% more than the people that I am sharing it with. And you might think that that's a little bit of a scam, but let me give you an example. I've got a lot of knowledge when it comes to economic cycles. That level of information is far above anything on YouTube. And when I have put out videos on this topic, a lot of people don't resonate with it. They don't follow it. They don't click onto it. They're not interested. So that level of knowledge, maybe it's the level of it, maybe it's just the topic itself, but people don't find it interesting. So you don't need to know everything there is about a particular subject. You just need to know a little bit more and be able to put that into a process that people are going to enjoy watching. They get a feeling that they can use that information and reach their end goal. So they've got a dream and you just got to get them to their dream. That's it. That's all you need in terms of the information and the knowledge you require to be able to put out a video and start teaching people about something that you love. So start thinking about unique skills that you have, things that you enjoy, stuff that people have mentioned to you in the past, like, oh, you know, you're really good at making a particular type of meal that is higher in fat and protein. You know, you're a bit more keto style. You're really good at creating recipes that come together and they taste really good and people are gonna want them. Building on top of that is affiliate marketing. So if you've started to grow your base, then you have products and services that you can use that meet your niche. So for example, I've got personal finance here. Things that meet my niche are exchanges, places where people can buy and sell assets. In particular, I've got cryptocurrency. So some crypto exchanges contact me. I get to do videos on them, providing I like their product. I think that's a big one as well. That's why I haven't done so much of it, because I haven't found many products that I really enjoy. But when I do, I like to talk about them, mention them here. I get links from those guys. And if you're interested in using the same product or service that I do, then you just use the link in the description down below, click on that and you get a few bucks and I get a few bucks. So that's just another way to create a little more income. Now you're probably thinking, what's the point of all this? There's just little bits of money here and there. I want something huge. I hate to be the bearer of bad news, but there is nothing like that. You got to start small, got to create, got to go through the process of learning how to build these sorts of funnels in order to be able to get the bigger money down the track. It just doesn't start like that. And with all of these previous options, there is also the option of running paid ads. Of course, you're going to need some cash for that, but if you are spending 10 bucks and you make back $11, then you're winning, you're in profit. So what you're doing is working. So continue on that path and keep doing that. Surely, if you're getting into this, you must have 10 bucks. No one is out there starting from zero. I don't care what they say. You're on YouTube, you've got a phone, you've got a computer, you're watching YouTube, you have money in the bank, you have something. You have money that you can get from somewhere if you want to use the ads model. So get into it, find the niche, get out there, start to create the plan. If you want to know more, hit me in the comments down below. There are tons of free resources on how to create funnel streams online. It is a very simple process. It takes time, but it's very enjoyable to learn at the same time. And it's a whole new skill that you can create for yourself. With that said, that can lead on to the next space that you can make money in, and that is freelancing. So you could start to freelance your skills out from something like learning how to do Facebook ads. I know many people that have done this. They start to learn how Facebook ads work. You watch a lot of YouTube videos, you learn for yourself, you play around with it, see how it all comes together. And providing you can make more money than you're spending in ads, you're winning. That's it, that's all it takes. You don't need to be creating some sort of 10x return from the get-go. As long as you're up, you're winning. That is a freelance job that you can do online, and that will carry on even after quarantine is done. How amazing is that? You could start to have a career online. You could start to become a digital nomad. You could work from home. You can work from anywhere in the world with that skill, and that skill is highly valued at this point in time in the market, especially with all of the ads being at such high priority for a lot of people. In particular, if you start to target guys who are running courses online, they have a big profit margin and they're willing to pay good money for someone that can create ads for them that are gonna sell their courses. You know these guys, they come up before these sorts of videos and they're selling stuff like, hey, buy my course to learn how to sell on Amazon. They have big margins and they're willing to pay good money. Another freelancing skill is copywriting. If you are a writer, and there are many creative people out there that are great at writing, if you can write and sell something from that writing, you've got a job for life. That is highly valuable in today's market and has been since the dawn of time. Anytime someone needs to sell something, as long as you can get them to feel something from what you have written or what you're presenting, and it meets their needs, they're going to buy that product. Okay, by now maybe you're saying, well, that's great, I don't have any of these skills, and then I have to go and build these skills, and hopefully I've still got some money left over by the time quarantine is over. Like, how am I gonna make money now? And if you find yourself in that situation, keep those ideas on the side. All of these things that I've mentioned here, the freelancing, the copywriting, YouTube channel from something that you love. But if you need something now, get started into a virtual assistant. Maybe you're in an office previously and you're an admin assistant, something like that. You can be a virtual assistant. Your costs are going to be lower because you're just working from home. You don't have to drive out to an office every day. You don't need all of the other expensive clothing and stuff like that to get into corporate. But of course, your hourly rate is going to be a little lower. If you have excellent skills within your base of whatever admin you're in and you can be a virtual assistant, some people are willing to pay a higher price for that because at the moment there's a lot of people online that are from third world countries, their English isn't so good. I'm not having a go at them whatsoever, they're doing the best that they can. But some people just, they don't wanna go through that hassle and they have the budget to pay someone higher. They don't need to pay someone at $5 an hour. They could pay someone at 15 or 20 US dollars an hour to get a whole lot of work done for them online. So go and check out those options if that is something for you. That's the virtual assistant. Moving back into the freelance space, and potentially now you've acquired some skills in the copywriting space, you've got some freelance skills in making Facebook ads, you've got something in YouTube, you've built something. Maybe you had something before this even started. You're a personal trainer or you had some other sort of business outside of this. The next thing is coaching. And coaching is kind of similar to the online courses, except you're doing it in real time with the person, which demands a higher price. It's not as scalable as creating an online course and then selling that out. But coaching, some people really love that. And I have found that extremely valuable in my time when I've gone through property investment courses, property development, trading, and again, there's many different types of trading, and I've paid for courses in all of these things and had a lot of live one-on-one time with guys who have been doing it for many years. And maybe you find yourself in that space. So coaching online, one-on-one, or in small group settings is another highly valuable way to make money online. And again, that's a digital product, a digital service, and you can take that with you even after this is finished. You go back to your everyday job after quarantine's done, or you find some other job you love in the part of the world that you live, you can always do this at night or in the mornings. There's plenty of time to get the coaching done, and maybe you can switch over eventually and travel full time doing your coaching. I've got a few more left, and I'll run through these quite quickly. I've got a translator. If you have a second language, you can translate for people online. You can write new captions for YouTube videos such as this. You could write ebooks for them, translate their ebooks, go online, find someone who has an ebook or some other course that is doing very well, offer to translate it for a price, for a fee, and continue that service, build your portfolio. Another thing to do is in the freelance space, and that could be if you're great at photography. If you have a backlog of photos or a huge catalog of videos, stuff like that, you can put these things onto sites like Shutterstock, and people pay for this stock image or stock video to have them onto their content. They can use them for their own videos such as this. You may have seen images and videos like that on my channel before, and I've used those from services that provide these photos and videos for me because I don't have the time to go out and take a whole ton of photos and videos from all different areas around the world. It's just easier to use that online, and many great YouTube channels do this model. They create mini documentaries and they just use a ton of stock footage. So if you have a backlog, because right now we're not really allowed out to be doing anything photography or videography based, then you can use that, upload that. That's a small stream of income, but it's passive and it's ongoing. So it's not a waste of time right now, but it's something that can continue on in the future. And the very last one requires money, so I thought I would leave it to the end, and that is interest. Interest paying banks, interest paying exchanges, those sort of things. And I'm primarily talking about cryptocurrency. There are a few of these which offer 10, 12, 18% return on your money. And of course, you're going to need some money at the beginning, but it's kind of a good way, even if you started building up some money from these services and products that I've mentioned earlier, there's another place that you can start to funnel these into and create another passive income from that money. And they're not all cryptocurrency that are fluctuating like the markets are at the moment, up 40%, down 50%. There are many which are one-to-one with a US dollar or one-to-one with Aussie dollar, British pound, euro, whatever it is. You can buy those cryptos which mimic the currency of that particular country as well. So you're not going to get that price fluctuation, but you're going to get 10 or 12% return on your money. One in particular, I've got a link down below for, it's called crypto.com. If you sign up, you get $50 worth of their token, MCO, and I also get $50 of that token as well. It's a good way to get started, and it just shows you how the process works. I've been using it for 12 months now. Payments are regular. So it's just a great way to earn a little bit of passive income. I mean, if you put enough in there, it becomes quite a great passive income. If you get 100 grand in there, you know, who's got 100 grand right now? But if you get 100 grand in there, making 12% per annum, there's 12 grand per annum, $1,000 a month. That's not too bad for not having to do anything. And you started to build up your portfolio, you've built everything up, you understand investing now. And it's just like a nice way to learn at the same time, earn a little bit of income. Now, at the beginning of the video, I said, these are some things that we all have seen and heard many times before, but a lot of us aren't doing that. And it comes down to mindset. It's like, why aren't we doing it? We know that they're out there. We know there's ways to make money, but what is it within us that isn't doing this? And that is what I pose to you right now. If you've listened to this whole video and you've thought, I could do some of them, but I'm not that interested in it right now because maybe there's a better option. I ask you to sit down with yourself, grab out a pen and paper, get your journal out and start to write down things around why you believe you can't do something. And then also put the pros as well, why you could do something, and really dive headfirst into the reasons why you think you're not able to make money right now. That is going to be the number one thing that stops you from creating something in this current market. These times in the economy, when we get huge crashes, they are when wealth is created. The real big generational wealth is created now. As the market's going up, you're making good money. As the market comes down, you're making great money. But when we get big falls, that is when the generational wealth is created. And now is not the time to be sitting on your hands. Now is the time to be out there learning as much as you can, keeping as much money for yourself, and then creating that into a generational wealth for you and your family and potentially their families in years to come. This is the time of opportunity. With that said, I'd love to thank you so much for watching this. I hope you found some value in there somewhere along the lines and you used your time very wisely in this. If you did, be sure to like the video down below. It really helps out the channel a lot. Of course, it gets me going in the algorithm, helps other people see the video, and I hope they can be helped in turn as well. I mean, that's why I do these videos, because I just love to help in the personal finance space and primarily the psychology within the personal finance. It's something that I'd struggled with for a long time, and now breaking through it, it just feels so good to be able to share that knowledge, learn more and share more. It's just like a cycle that doesn't end, and it gives me a lot of energy. That's why I love to be on here. And if you haven't already, be sure to subscribe down below and hit the bell notification icon too. Many of you watch these videos and you haven't subscribed, so I'd really appreciate it if you did that too. If you want to join me for more, I'm on Instagram and Facebook. Again, the links are down below. You can ask me questions there anytime. And possibly I'll make a video on them for you. I'll wrap it up there because you've listened to my voice long enough. I'll see you guys at the next video. Be sure to stick around and check out my other videos on the channel around personal finance and mindset strategies. I'll see you at the next one. Until then, take care and have more fun to get more done.